However, them get me on my wrong side again.
That me say.
Right now, me just make them know some me a certain boy and a friend.
Now. Try to fast it.
Nah, nah, nah. Some me things, sir. Ja, 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 yeah, yeah. Ah, na, 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 na. Them a go get defeat, get defeat. Anything fierce we get, kaful and reach. Get defeat, them a go get defeat. Anything fierce we get.
Greetings, students. Today we'll be looking at the if statement. Now, the if statement is a conditional statement. Conditional meaning that depending on what the user inputs, determine which direction the program is going to go. So, it's a slightly different from the while loop, but it's basically it basically allows you to allow the user options to choose from. And the two best examples I could think of are the ATM machine. Everybody at some point in their life interact with the ATM machine. And you're given choices. You're either being asked to what? Deposit, to check your balance, to withdraw, or to transfer. Now, of course, there are other options, but just for the sake of my example, I'm using some basic inputs. All right. So now, the ATM machine is the hardware. The software now is written in such a way so that you have a choice. And what you choose determines the direction the software goes in. So if you choose deposit, it will take you to the deposit menu and ask you if you're depositing a check or cash, or if you're depositing into your saving account or your checking account, etc., etc. If you're withdrawing, the same applies. It will ask you if you're withdrawing from your savings account, or it will ask you if you're withdrawing from your checking account, and so on. Or if you're transferring, it will ask you if you want to transfer from your account, or if you want to like give somebody credit or something like that. Various ATM machines have a variety of options on them that allow them to do many things. The next example I thought of was the cell phone. So the phone itself is the hardware, but the software that runs it gives you options. Now, whether it's Android or ISO or iPhone or whatever, it doesn't matter. What matters is that the structure of the software is still the same. You have options to choose from. If you press 30 seconds, it will activate the 30 second program. If you press 1 minute, it will activate the 1 minute program. Whatever that is, whether it's to sleep after 1 minute, play the song for 1 minute, whether it's to alarm in 1 minute, whatever it is. The if statement is what is used to give you these options. Okay, so here's our first question. Write a pseudocode that requests students' grades from the user. If a grade that is less than 50 is entered, you fail should be printed to the screen. If a grade greater than 50 is entered, then you pass will be entered to the screen. Now bear in mind, these questions are geared to get you to understand how to interpret the questions. So if you go up to CXE levels, the questions will not be this detailed. You just have to know creatively in your mind or logically in your mind what to do. So these questions are very basic and they're written in such a way to get you to understand the structure of the pseudocode. So bear that in mind when you're reading my questions. Okay, so let's analyze the question. It says, write a pseudocode that requests grades from the user. So what are you asking for? Grades. Okay, so right away you have an idea of what your variable will be called. Doesn't have to be grades, can still use num and integer and all of those, but if the question talks about grades, why not use grades? Okay, if a grade that is less than 50 is entered, you fail should be printed to the screen. So right away we know now that we have to print you fail to the screen, and we know the correct keyword to use for that. If a grade greater than 50 is entered, then you pass will be entered to the screen. So right away we know that's the second thing we're going to print, and that is that if the user enters a grade greater than 50, which is between 50 and anything up, then we know that you pass will be printed to the screen. So the person has a choice. either they can enter a grade greater than 50 or less than 50. And to accomplish this in the programming world, we use the if statement. No matter which language you're using, the structure of it is still the same. Even if the syntax changes, the structure of it is still the same. So, we start with what? Our start program, first of all, to start the pseudocode. Then, at the end of it, we'll have our end program. But just a convenience, I've already added start and end program at the top and the below, just to make it sync, just to make it more memorable in your mind. So, we have our start program, we have our end program. And then I have declared my variable, which in this case is what? Grade. So grade is what I'm calling my variable. Please note, it doesn't have to be zero like what you're accustomed to. I've already explained to you that we use the number that best accomplishes our goal. So our goal here is to test what number the user has entered. Once again, we have start, end. Okay, still have our grade variable, and then we have what? The 50 inside the grade variable. I'm using the keyword print to ask the user to do what? Enter a grade. Then, after I have asked the user for the grade, then I use the keyword read to read in the grade that the user has entered. Now we're getting into the nitty-gritty. So the structure of the if statement always begins with a begin if and always ends with a end if. Just like how the pseudocodes always start with start program and then ends with end program, it's the same thing. Within the if statement, we set our condition. In this case, I have set my condition to be less than 50. So, the whole statement reads, if the grade is less than 50, then it will carry out some action. Now, bear in mind that we did not have to use less than 50. We could have used greater than 50, depending on how we wanted to write the pseudocode. Because you determine how your program runs. So there's more than one way to write it. There's not necessarily one way to write it. So I'm writing using less than 50. But like I said, you can also use greater than 50. You'll see the effects of it in a moment. Now, I have started with my begin if. I have put in my end if. Then I set my conditional statement to be what? Less than 50. If the grade entered is less than 50, then the program will do what? It will print, you have failed. All right. Now, because it says less than 50, and in the question it says, if the person gets less than 50, you have failed. That is why I put you have failed first. If I had put greater than 50, then I would have to put here, so you have passed. See the difference? Because this condition only has two options, which are either you fail or you pass. And what is separating them? The else. The else tells the program that if the person enters less than 50, then it's going to print this. But if the person enters a number that is greater than 50, then it will print this. And this is the basic structure of the if statement. Now bear in mind, like I said before, it doesn't matter which language you're using. The structure will always be the same. So maybe you won't write the if statement in this manner. Maybe use some colons, some semicolons, some different kind of brackets, you know, periods, full stops, whatever. But the structure is still the same, whichever program you're using. And of course, we would have the end if at the end of the if statement, and then we'd have end program at the end of the pseudocode. Okay, so let's look at the second question. This question says, write a pseudocode that allows students to choose between mathematics and English as a subject. The student's choice should be printed to the screen. Okay, so right away we know, based on the worded question, that we have a choice. And when we have choice, we know we're going to use the if statement. Okay.
Do you want to know what it is? The matrix is everywhere. It is all around us. Even now, in this very room. You can see it when you look out your window or when you turn on your television. You can feel it when you go to work, when you go to church, when you pay your taxes. It is the world that has been pulled over your eyes to blind you from the truth.
What truth?
That you are a slave, Neo. Like everyone else, you were born into bondage, born into a prison that you cannot smell or taste or touch. A prison for your mind. Unfortunately, no one can be told what the Matrix is. You have to see it for yourself. This is your last chance. After this, there is no turning back. You take the blue pill. The story ends. You wake up in your bed and believe whatever you want to believe. You take the red pill. You stay in Wonderland. And I show you how deep the rabbit hole goes. Remember, all I'm offering is the truth, nothing more.
So let's analyze the question. Any question at all you get, whether in mathematics or in programming or in English, please practice to read the question 3 times. Read it once to see what the question is asking. Read it a second time to pick out details. After you finish answering the question, read it a third time to ensure that you've answered the question. Because some students, we ask them to find perimeter and they find area. We ask them to find area and they find perimeter. It's like these two topics are twins or something. So please be mindful of worded questions. Please read them. Don't be afraid to underline key points or keywords. Don't be afraid to ask yourself questions. And like I said before, my questions are geared to get you to understand the concept of the if statements. So the CXC questions that you might see will not be this simplistic. It will be more general. All right, let's go. So it says write a pseudocode that allows students to choose. So you know you have a choice there, not true. So what structure do we use to choose in pseudocode? The if statement. Between what? What are we going to choose between? Mathematics and English as a subject, right? The student's choice should be printed to the screen. So that's the command section of the question. That's the part of the question that we are going to carry out. Alright, so I started with my start program, during my end program, and I chose to declare a variable called integer. So I have declared my variable, called it integer. I have initialized it to 0. Now, the reason why I only declared one integer is because I only need one number, which is 1. If it is 1, the way all this pseudocode is structured, if the person press 1, then the choice will be English. If the person press any other number, the choice would automatically be mathematics. This is how this pseudocode is structured, because I'm only using one integer. So as long as the person press 1, English will be the option that's selected. But if the person press any other number, it will automatically be mathematics. I'll explain it in detail in a little while. So, after we have asked the person to press 1, 1 for English, 2 for mathematics, then we do what? Then we read in the variable integer. These little syntax and semantics cause your programs not to run. Bear that in mind when you're writing them, because programming language is very specific. Okay, so we read in the integer. Let's look at the next slide. Right, so start program still there. Integer is still initialized to 0. We're asking the user to press 1 or press 2 for mathematics. We are reading in the integer. Then I'm what? Beginning my if with a begin if statement. Then what? I'm beginning my if statement with a begin if. If the integer is equal to 1, then what will the program do? The program will print, "You have chosen English." Please bear in mind that the user would only see "You have chosen English." They would not see the print. They would not see the quotation marks. Please bear that in mind. When you go to the ATM or use your phone, you don't see the programming language. All you see are the options that the phone is offering. That's all you see. You don't see the programming language. It's the same thing in pseudocode. Even though the pseudocode would not run, but still, the user would only see "You have chosen English." So, in this case, it's what? Testing the integer variable to see if it contains 1. If it contains 1, then it will print, "You have chosen English." Then we use the else now to separate the choice. If the person press any other number other than 1, it will print, "You have chosen mathematics." So this is due to the way how I wrote the pseudocode. And in a way, this is sloppy programming, but I just wanted to understand the structure of it so that when we go on to the nested if, you get a better understanding.
Do not try and bend the spoon. That's impossible. Instead, only try to realize the truth.
What truth?
There is no spoon.
There is no spoon?
Then you'll see that it is not the spoon that bends. It is only yourself.
The Oracle will see you now.
Okay, by popular demand, here is the nested if. Alright, so here we go. The question says, write a pseudocode that... The question says, write a pseudocode that allows students to choose between mathematics and English as a subject. Sound familiar, right? The student's choice should be printed to the screen. All right. So we have two choices to make. Either it's mathematics or it is English. And then we're going to do what? Print the student's choice to the screen. So that's the command part of the question. So if you don't print the student's choice to the screen, then you haven't answered the question, or at least not in full, because you get part marks for everything you do. Okay, so as in the previous example, we start program, I'm still using integer as my variable, and I'm initializing it to 0. I'm asking the user to press 1 or to press 2. And please bear in mind, the user would only see, please press 1 for English, please press 2 for mathematics. They would not see the syntax surrounding the statements. Then what? I read in my integer. I'm beginning the if statement now with a begin if. So if the integer is equal to 1, then the program will do what? Print you have chosen English to the screen. Else, remember else is the divider, I'm starting now another begin if. So the first begin if is to test and give the results if the person enters 1 into that integer there. This if now, which is the second if, starts with another begin if, and this time I'm testing to see if the integer, if the number in the integer is equal to 2. So it's testing for two specific things. It's testing for 1 or it's testing for 2. Alright, so we put another else in there now. Now so far we've had how many else? We have 1 and we have 2, so we have 2 else. So this else is separating this if, in a sense, from this if, even though it's a if within a if, which is called a nested if. This else is giving us a third option now. If the person enters 1, it will print you have chosen English to the screen. If the person enters 2, then it will print you have chosen mathematics to the screen. Suppose the person doesn't press 1 or 2. Suppose the person presses 0. Alright, if the person presses 0, or if the person presses 5, then it will go into this else, and it will say, that is not a valid option. Some of you have used the phone system, where you've tried to call for help, waste your credit, trying to get somebody to answer your question, and then they say press 1 to speak to a customer representative, press 2 to check your balance, press 3 for internet services, and then you press 4 by accident because the phone buttons are small. And then it says that is not a valid option. Then it repeats again. Now that repeat part, it's what? The while loop. Not you. Everybody should know that by now. But to choose if you press 1, 2, or 3, that is the if statement. And that condition is used to determine what direction the program takes based on the user's input. And of course, we have another end if. Now bear in mind that there are two end ifs here. This one, first one, would be for the nested end if, which would coincide with this begin if here. So, and then this end if here would coincide with the begin if, the big begin if up top. Right, so we have two begin if, we have two else, and we have two end if, but we only have one end program though, realize that. And this is called the nested if. Now if you compare this question to the question previously, you would notice that it only said print please press 1 for English and 2 for mathematics, and then it didn't give you two options. That's the variety in programming that you can have. It's not a one hard and fast rule that you must do it this way. So this would look more like a menu to the user, and they would just read through and press. But the other one is more faulty. In order to write good programs, you need to think through the program first. Think through the structure each step, and then apply what you have thought of to the language in order to get the results that you desire. So just bear in mind that this is just one style, and in the previous question it was a different way of doing it. It doesn't mean that either of them is wrong necessarily. It's just that this way to me is more preferably better, because it makes your program more specific, and there's less likely a chance for errors. Alright, so here's a question. Do this question on your own, please. Now in the type notes called how to write a pseudocode if statement, you will see additional questions and additional examples. Here I've given you three basic examples so that you can comb through it and try to understand its structure. When you read through the notes, you'll get all the different examples and understand the structure of the if statement. So here's a question that you can try. Develop a pseudocode that registers students for school based on their age. If the student is younger than 12, then they should be registered as a primary school student. If the students are older than 12, should be than. If they are older than 12, they should be registered as a high school student. The type of student has been registered for. The type of school the student has been registered for should be printed to the screen. Okay, so now we're being asked to give the user the option of two choices. Either you're older than 12 or you are less than 12. Now, let's reason out this question. This is why I tell you to read it three times. So you're developing a registration system for a school. If the student is younger than 12, which is one option, younger than 12, so that means 11, 10, 9 go straight down, right? That includes everybody under 12. Now, would 12 be included in that? Do 12-year-olds go to high school? This is why I told you that you have to spend time and think through your program. So if 12-year-olds go to high school, that means that we would have to use an equal to or a less than, which is this symbol down here. Equal to, that little dash at the below, and less than. Alright, and if they are older now than 12, then if we were going to write the program that way, we would write it as a greater than with the slash at the below to say that it is what? Equal to. So it's equal to or greater than 12. Right? So it depends. You can use either one of them, either less than or the greater than. Either one of them will give you the same results. It's just a matter of you just applying whichever one you want to apply. Just like the previous example with the 50, I could have used less than 50, I could have used greater than 50. But suppose the person got 50, we didn't include that in the pseudocode. We just said less than 50 or greater than 50. If that was an actual program and the person got 50, then the program would freeze, it wouldn't run because it did not write any option in it. But like I'm showing you, this is just to show you the structure of the if statement. So as you get more advanced questions, you'll refine it and you'll be able to think it through better in a logical way so that you create the software to accommodate all the different nuances and pathways that can pop up. So we're choosing between less than 12 or equal to 12 or greater than or equal to 12. And based on that, we know we would use these two symbols. So please take a snapshot of this question and attempt it. Send me the pseudocode that you've written and mark it and send it back to you and give you feedback, give you advice. Thank you.
Tell me I be work, 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 work. You see me do me dirt, 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 dirt. That's how me better work, 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 work. When you walk a line, 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 line. I'm in the cafe, my ta, 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 ta. Drive me, I deserve it. No time to have you lurking. You make a like, now you don't like it. You know I dealt with you the nicest. Nobody touched me in the right. Nobody text me in a crisis. I believed all of your dreams are duration. You took my heart, all my keys, and my patience. You took my heart, I must leave a decoration. You mistaken my love, I brought for you for foundation. All that I wanted from you was to give me something that I never had. Something that you never seen. Something that you never been. But I wake up and nothing's wrong. Just get ready for work, 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 work. You tell me I be work, 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 work. You see me do